Good afternoon, everybody. I'm here basically to share my experiences rather than telling some philosophy. And I believe, and I'm a firm believer in the dictum, is the mind which decides our own boundaries, our social boundaries, or our national boundaries. If we decide to overcome those boundaries in mind, action will follow. And that's what we do in our daily lives. What motivates us is the same thing. When I work as a public servant, as a civil servant, I believe it's an opportunity for me to do something good, to contribute to the public good, of which I have been a part, I have been given an opportunity to work for. It's an inner conscious, the conscious keeping of oneself, which keeps on asking me, if you can't, who else can? And that motivates me again and again to do the better, the more, whatever I can in different capacities wherever I work. Either as a district collector, as a chief executive officer, or a commissioner, or maybe in different position as a in a public transport sector. And this is one field where, as an IAS officer, we get opportunities to learn more, to do more in different fields. One of the unique services in the world, which could have different experiences and contribute in different fields. In our lives, we have times when we decide to take a particular path. And if we capture that path, that moment, in the right directions, you are destined to do better. If you decide to do other way, it can go the wrong way. It happened in my career very early. When I was appointed and undergoing a training in a particular district, I started working as a hands-on experience in one of the councils. As a young blood, we take a lot of decisions, right or wrong, for learning so that you make right decisions in your career and contribute in a better manner as a public servant. One of the decisions which I took in the first 3-4 months of my career was to remove different encroachments in the city. I started working on it, started removing the encroachments in the city, and as usual, there are different approaches to look at the issue. The one way to look at it was making it clean, better city to live. On the other hand, the lives of the people who were removed were at stake. Their bread and butter was being challenged. By following due processes of the law, on Monday I started removing the encroachments, say around at 12 o'clock. And immediate there was a resistance. The people gathered and said, no, you can't remove it. We have the issues, you don't have any right, so we'll do things. And he stood. Rather than sitting in the office, I decided to be on the field, leading from the front, and remove those encroachments. By the turn of 2 hours, a person comes in the group and says that I would be immolating myself if you demolish this, my shanty, which was illegal. And he was doing the business of liquor selling, which was again illegal. And threatening to say that I immolate myself if you dare touch or move further. And as a result, these are the occasions when you make a decision. Had I stopped at that point in time, I would not be able to remove the encroachments which were lined up, and they were in the range of 1500 to 2000 encroachments on the public roads, on the boundaries of the public roads, which are actually blocking the roads and the spaces which are meant for mobility and the utility of the public. The police advised me to stop and start the next day afresh. But that was the moment I said, no, this is the time, I am not getting back. I went to the person, asked, if you are threatening, I will arrest you. I asked the police to capture him, went ahead, removed those encroachments. By the end of the day, almost 100 encroachments were removed on both sides of the road. But that was not enough. The second day continued, third day continued. By the time I was continuing, more than 50%, 60% encroachments were being removed by people themselves. Because once people know, it's no point in resisting. Whatever we have, we should carry, otherwise that will also lost to them. And after 3 days, 3.5 days time, the almost encroachment removal is complete. The next day morning, I again go to my office around 9 o'clock, 9:30, 10. I sit in the office. And few ladies come to meet me, saying that we want to congratulate you. You have done a great job for the city, you are cleaning up the city, so we can live a better life now. Surprisingly, the guards which are protecting me, because encroachment being a very sensitive subject, very volatile subject, they prevented them to enter my chamber. And I was astonished. But I thought there must be some reason why the guards have been cautious enough not to allow somebody to enter in my chamber, where I generally met and keep meeting the people so that I come to know the issues and I can deliver on the services. It's around 12 o'clock. This incident happened at 10 o'clock. This is around 12 o'clock. I get a call from police officer saying there is an issue. And people have gathered in front of the police station wanting to file FIR against you. And I was a little bit surprised why FIR would be filed against me. And I asked him, what is the issue? He said that there is an issue, it is being sorted out. Once it is over, I'll let you know. So I was not aware of what is happening on the ground. I was in the office. I was not allowed to meet anybody. Just imagine that was the situation when I had just entered 8-9 months training in Mussoorie and 3-4 months in the field. And around 1 o'clock, I get a call, the issue has been resolved. And I inquired what has happened. The answer was this: some people, particularly ladies, had come to file an FIR against you, saying that I have violated the law and there is a molestation case against you. And that molestation case, along with atrocity, the provisions of which mandate registration of legal case against you, which was there. The fact of the matter was that nothing of this sort had happened. But because I had removed encroachments, whoever might have hurt and whoever might be behind supporting these people might be promoting these cases. And then I thought, have I done something wrong? I have followed the due process of law. And I being targeted for doing the right job. Is encroachment legal? The answer is no. Is encroachment the means to live? The answer is no. Is it good for society? Answer is no. Are the public authorities in different capacities expected to remove it? Answer is yes. And the precisely what I had done was the same thing. And when I probed further, I came to know that the ladies who wanted to file FIR and who had filed a complaint against me in the police station were the same one who had come in the morning to meet me in the office. And the plan later on which came to know was this: in the guise of garlanding me, they wanted to do something, tearing up their own clothes or something like that, and file FIR against me on molestation grounds. Just imagine a situation where you are just entrant in a particular field, acting in a particular capacity, whether public or private or individual cases, where you think that you are doing right job, most of the people think that you are right job, your seniors also think that you are doing right job, and you are faced with such a situation. What you do? It was nothing less than a shocker for me. And I was thinking, what is to be done? What have I done? Have I done something wrong? Have I chosen the wrong path in the public service to do this kind of things, the right things, the correct things, the things which are expected to be done by public servant and in the public interest as per the law? So it was that 15-20 minutes which I thought, why I have come in this service, what is the objective that I have come, and what is I am going to achieve if this type of situation arises at the beginning of my career? Have I chosen the right path? And I think that was the turning point in my career where I could choose either of the ways, where I could leave the path which I had chosen, that doing the right things in the public interest, or leave that path and neglect it. No, that is a sensitive issue, leave it. We have 100 other issues we should touch upon. So we pick and choose what you are supposed to do. And at the end of the thought, at the end of 15-20 minutes, I consciously chose the path which I have chosen. I will tread that same path come what may. And from that day onwards today, I have been following that path, and I don't have any regrets about whatever happened in last 10-12 years time. The same action when it was going on, I had faced a lot of issues. One of the issues was very sensitive issue. I was removing the encroachments on both sides of the roads, and there was one point when it came, almost 85-year-old lady was staying in a shanty on the side of the road along with other encroachers. She had also had a shanty over there. She had no dependents, neither sons, nor daughters, no parents, no brother, no sister. And there were encroachments beyond that shanty also. And she was crying. If that shanty is removed, what is to be done? What would happen to her? And I asked whether we should remove it or not to remove it. I had a decision to make, and the decisions had impact on my total approach. If I leave that shanty, I cannot remove other encroachments. If I remove that shanty, the absolute destitute woman come on the road, 85-90 year old, eyes, tears in the eyes, what do I do? I took decision to remove it. The next day headline was the crying woman, and whether this public administration or the policy or the officer has human touch or not. This situation come in our life as an individual, as a public leader, in different capacities, and you have to make a decision. And that's where the dilemma, whether it's legal versus ethical. Do you strictly follow what is legal and leave aside ethical things so that you are regarded as a so-called strict officer, you are doing your job? And this situation taught me what is to be done. Legal versus ethical dilemma, what I thought or decided over there, and I apply standards. We as public servants or citizens cannot overrule the legalities, we have cannot compromise it. What we need to do is discuss about ethical issues. And I believe legal and ethical issues are not contradictory, they are not each versus other. They actually go hand in hand. So, but what we have to think is public ethics or public morality rather than individual morality. And as a result, what is public interest versus individual interest? So if I choose individual interest of that particular lady, I lose sight of public interest as a whole of that town. And that's why I apply different aspects, including whether it's a public interest, whether it's a public morality, and I give weightage to public morality and public interest rather than to individual interest and individual morality. That I have been doing over last 10, 12 years in my career in different capacities. As I believe in Gandhi's dictum, we always believe that society should be non-corrupt, public administration or policy making should absolutely non-corrupt, everybody is corrupt. We expect that everybody should be transparent, result-oriented, but do we tread the path? It has to begin with us. So as Gandhi said, be the change you want to see. And I myself try to walk that path as a change maker, as a leader in that particular capacity. I believe in transformation rather than incremental changes. And that's where whatever initiative I take, whether walk with Commissioner in Navi Mumbai, where I was going to different wards, different areas in the morning to talk to the people so that I come to know what are their issues. I would solve that. It helped me solve hundreds and hundreds of issues which were facing the citizens of that area. Whether it's taking, working on land mafia, it's working on water conservation, making tanker fed district to tanker free district, or public transport in Pune. What would I like you people, all of us, to see is transform the nation by being a part of it, where services are hassle free, where ease of serving and ease of servicing is easier, so that we can build the nation as a young generation. So that's where whatever dreams you have, as I believe in I have a dream speech, so everybody has a dream. Please set the goal for yourself. Once you set the goal, that will become a boundary. You have to cross the boundaries, and once you set for yourself that goal, you can achieve with your dreams. Thank you.